Firstly, we must realize that in an informal manner, Fatah's economy is considerably integrated with KP. Because the Fatah region is not one complete unit in one place. It stretches from the north to the south. And most of the agencies actually have linkages with the towns or the centers close by. For example, you know, Lundi Kotal has Peshawar. If you go on to the north Waziristan, it has Bannu and so on and so forth. South Waziristan has Ziya Khan. So there is a fair amount of integration. Of course, in terms of services, a lot of services are accessed by Fatah in the KP. I mean, higher education, for example, health, tertiary healthcare, mostly. So there is already a considerable amount of social and economic integration, though at an informal level. What is likely to happen with integration is that you'll have to look at more formal structures. You will have to think of economic regulation, which has to be extended. Because without that kind of regulatory and institutional structures, to expect normal, normative private sector activity or investment to take place in Fatah, or for that matter, Fatah and the KP to formally also become one market would be difficult. And that is, I think, going to be the primary challenge. Now, at the moment, of course, what is really happening is that if somebody is going to look into all this, it's probably going to be led by the federal government. But it's important, and that's the point I was trying to make, that we let economic integration lead it, rather than purely political structures or administrative structures being at the forefront. We should think of the economic integration first. And if that is to happen, then KP has to take the lead. It has to have a senior seat at the table.